local youth, provide employment. It's not a commercial reason, it's nothing else, right? It's like, you know, the opportunities are everywhere. It's how you grab it, how you go out and you grab it. If you start undermining your skills, if you start thinking you are lower than anybody else, if you start thinking that you're not capable, that's the first step of your failure, okay? You need to have the positive attitude, like, I can do this, and I'm no less than anybody else, right? So I don't know how many of you actually follow the, I don't think you know the ice hockey. You know hockey, right? Hockey also. So in American countries, especially colder countries, there's a game called ice hockey. It's very popular, right? Ice hockey, they're actually skating and playing in hockey. Very fast game, very wild game. So you really have to take a lot of shots to get the goal. The goal is very small, like this big. And the goalie is like a wicket keeper lag, or like, you know, the goalkeeper lag. He's actually as big as a goal, right? So how do you make a goal when everyone says, this guy is actually blocking it, right? You need to take more shots. So there's a famous player, like Sachin Tendulkar of cricket, Wayne Gretzky. Wayne Gretzky or Martin Brodeur, very famous player. Somebody was asking him an interview and said, like, you know, why do you take so many shots? Something from some interview. He says, you will miss every shot. You will miss 100% of the shots that you don't take. Right? So pay attention to that. Right? It's a very popular saying. It's not my saying. It's actually Wayne Gretzky's saying. He's a very, very, very great guy. He said, you will miss the 100% of the shots that you don't take. Right? Fail like on a bayonet teaspoon shot, at least 100% may miss out there. The first step that you take, right? You may fail, but at least you're taking first step. There's a 1% chance that you succeed, right? So if you go with that attitude, then you are a great person, nobody else. But at the same time, make sure to have the respect for people who teach you. Nina Gopal Karma, Jipin Rakhpatamakla. So, when walking in, I really don't know what you guys are. I really have no idea, no background. Now, one uncle just came and said, like, what if you talk to them? So I just walk in. I really don't have an agenda, a topic, or anything. So let's make it more interesting and interactive, right? So you can ask any question that you want. I'll try in capital letters, try to answer if possible, as much as I can. But I'll be very honest with my answers. Okay? So let's make it interactive. And if something comes out of it, I'll tell you. Okay? Then we'll talk about, like, you know, I know, by the way, Raju Reddy Garu, who started this whole sandbox, and with the help of Reddy Garu, right? I know about this foundation. I know what they're doing. I know their purpose. And I really, really admire it. The reason we volunteer to give the college to space also is one of the reasons. I know Raju, of course, we know him personally, friendly, but at the same time, we know the intentions, what they want, what they're trying to do, right? I went to Nizamabad about a couple of months ago, March, when I was in India, went to Nizamabad. When I went to Nizamabad and when I was interacting with some of the people, it was an eye-opener, okay? I'll tell you about my experience after the program and why I think it's different after some of the interactions, okay? So feel free to ask any question that you want. You can ask about me, family, where I come from, what I've done, what I do, everything and anything you want, but don't make it too personal. So I prefer for you to give your name and where you come from. That way at least you know, go ahead please.
My name is Shyamsar. I'm from Nalgonda. I'm joining the Pillar Fellowship. So I want to ask you, sir, by watching you only I'm getting impressed, sir. Really, I'm telling that. So, but when I was coming from the lab, I'm looking at you and I got very impressed. So, who is this, sir? But I want that charming, sir, like you, I want to talk with you. Anyway, so I want to interact with another person like you only. So, can you give me any suggestions for that?
By the way, thank you. I think it's a compliment. Right?
Plus,
I'll tell you why, right? Just imagine, right? Just click, close your eyes for a second. I'm walking in, I have literally no idea what your program is. Now, already I was kind enough to walk me through some of the programs. Although he was updating me some of the issues, I really don't know. Right? So when I'm walking in, my only goal is to interact with you, talk to you. I don't have any personal agenda in my mind. I don't take anything out of this. But you know what I get? The energy that from you when you're talking, right? I get that energy. So I have selfishness a little bit, but other than that, I don't have anything. Right? Most of the times what happens is when you are walking in a very talking to some people, you can sit down, please. Right? You can sit down and ask, you don't have to be too formal. It's your confidence. It's your confidence, like, you know, the courage that you have, the confidence that you have, right? And knowledge that, you know, don't be overconfident. The confidence that, okay, I know what I know, and I'm willing to learn what I don't know. Right? That is what gives you the advantage, right? Need to be humble. And always, like, you know, don't ever think that you know better than anybody else. But at the same time, don't think that you don't know anything and don't be inferior, don't be timid. That's a lot of main reasons when you walk into the room, just go there with a plain heart. If you don't have any negative intention in your heart, then everything will be normal. Right? You don't have any negative intention, you don't have a personal agenda. Then you can go to room, even in front of Pramesh Kumori or anybody else, right? You will be the same person. The minute you start acting, the minute you start thinking that you're trying to be too obedient, or trying to be impress somebody else, that with you don't what you don't have, then you start failing. When you there is this good question for one reason, right? Tomorrow you'll go for an interview. When you're going for an interview, what do they look at? Your knowledge, your attitude, right? And your confidence levels in achieving something. Right? I'll tell you, you know, how many of you know the blind school in Nalgonda? How many of you know of the blind school in Nalgonda?
I don't know.
There's a blind school in Nalgonda right next to bus station. I don't know the area, right? It's very close to that. So about 7-8 years ago I went there. There's a video on YouTube which actually I edited and posted on YouTube long time back. You know, it's about 7-8 minutes a video. Look through that. Watch that video. Then you will understand the confidence. Right? And I was talking to them. One of the questions, I asked them a question, what do you want to do? You know, the answer actually, you know, the confidence levels, right? I said, what do you want? He said, sir, we don't want anything. Just don't pity us. Don't pity us. Like, you know, mommy, the jar is perfect. Just treat us as another individual, another human being. I think all the confidence level, right? They can't see anything, but when they all they want to hear is they want you to treat them as another individual. Just another human being. I think all the confidence level. I think they, right? They cannot be independent. But they don't have the problem. Question of up and again. Right? Hey, what do you want to do? I said, okay, I want to be a singer. And he says, like an RP Patnaik, I would be able to. Or a discussion I'm going to be able to. There's another gentleman called Srinivas Reddy.